This is Kim Meyer with the Nutrient and Pest Management Program at the University of Wisconsin-Madison. Today I'm going to show you the basics of soil sampling. Soil sampling is important as it provides a foundation for making informed decisions on fertility on your farm on a field-by-field basis. Soil sampling needs to be done at a minimum of one sample per 5 acres, and you need to have at least one sample per field. If you have a field that is over 5 acres, you will need to take additional samples. For example, field 2 is 8.6 acres. Two samples will need to be taken from this field. I have the two areas marked out on the map, sample 1 and sample 2. Most soil sample bags have 3 lines, farm name, field, and sample number. Once you have marked your maps and labeled your bags, you'll need to collect tools for sampling in the field. You'll need a soil sample probe, a bucket for mixing your samples, a container to carry your samples, your labeled bags, and a map. In field 2, I'm going to take 2 samples. I'm going to break the field into 2 sections and take a composite sample from each section. Travel the first half of the field in a W pattern, stopping 10 times, taking a soil core each time you stop. In a field that is typically chisel plowed, you will want to sample to 3/4 of the depth of tillage. In this field, tillage is 8 inches, so we're going to sample 6 inches deep. Avoid sampling in areas such as manure piles, rows where fertilizer has been banded, eroded knolls, low spots, or headlands. Now that I've collected my 10 cores from the first half of the field, I'm going to mix them together to make 1 composite sample. And now I'm going to place this mixed sample into my pre-labeled bag. I finished sampling the second half of field 2 and completed sampling the remainder of the farm. I'm at the UW Soil and Plant Analysis Lab, one of the DATCAP approved labs in the state. I'm here to meet with John Peters, the director of the lab. So I brought all my soil samples in and I filled out my soil submission sheet.
Okay, it's important that this is done properly by the farmer because every laboratory runs tens of thousands of samples, so we have to make sure that information from here goes through the lab and then comes back on the report so the farmer can match it with where the sample was taken. Looks like you've done an excellent job here. Every line should be just one field. You can have multiple samples for larger fields, certainly, but one line per field. This year we added a box for tiling, so if a field is tiled, you can check that. Also, the other boxes remain the same for as we've had in the past. Plow depth is listed here, and if you're plowing deeper than 7 inches, then it's important to put that down because it affects the lime recommendation. Soil name is required, and you've got the soil name here, and also county of origin. Both of those affect our nitrogen recommendations. The other thing that's important and sometimes is forgotten is the farmer put down the crop sequence of what they want to grow and their yield goal, because that affects our recommendations. If they don't list anything here, we just have to assume they're growing corn and alfalfa and soybeans and probably not the rotation that they're interested in. Out on the right side here is our place for our nutrient credits, both legume and manure. If you know what's going to be applied to the field, you can put it on here. If not, you can add it, the information in later using SNAP Plus software. And lastly, on the bottom, if you want any special tests run, you know, based on the crop you're growing and the soil type, you can indicate that here and then the lab can do that for you.
For more information on soil sampling, refer to publication A2100, Sampling Soils for Testing, which can be found on the UW Soil Testing Lab website, or contact your local extension office.